Hello? Is it me you're looking for? Yeah. It's your boy Frankie, and I'm back for another reaction video today, man. Just want to say shout out to all the love I've been getting on my last reaction videos, man. Y'all been going crazy. Appreciate y'all, boys, man. But in typical fashion, we got some old Drake and Kendrick Lamar news, man. Yes, sir, we got some more news. So apparently, Drake went ahead and dissed Kendrick Lamar again. Again? Why would you do that? So I saw the post that they talking about. So Drake posted on his Instagram the other day, and the caption was "One Trick Ponies" or something like that. Something about one trick ponies. I didn't think it was directed at Kendrick Lamar, but apparently the whole internet did. So today we're gonna be reacting to why Drake just dissed Kendrick Lamar again. So shout out to Fantastic Hip Hop. That's the original creator of this video. I will link it in the description as typical fashion. But y'all already know that's another ad. Chad and Ken, let's get right into it.
This public meltdown that has been going on from Drake ever since the aftermath of the Kendrick beef has only been getting worse and worse with each passing moment that we're watching the dust settle and see how Drake is coping with the entire situation. And while embarrassing songs like Drake's Hey There Delilah parody were painstaking enough,
that was
for Drake. He isn't just trying to gain some sort of ground back in the rap game right now by releasing more music and trying to win over any sort of goodwill he can from people, but also in this very moment, Drake just came out and straight up dissed Kendrick Lamar again, but not musically this time, but with an Instagram post, okay, which shows off Drake at what looks like his son Adonis's.
First off, like, I don't know if all of y'all on Instagram, but most people are on Instagram, so y'all probably saw this image one way or another if you follow Drake or if you follow the Shade Room or any of those types of pages. Now, when we take a look at this outfit, like, can somebody tell me what he was going for? Like, it looks like he was going for, like, a 90s golf player type, but, like, I guess the fit would have been cool. Like, it ain't horrible, right? But why the pants so big? Pause. No diddy. It threw me off. It threw me off, bro. And to all the allegations that Drake been on the Ozempic, I don't know. I ain't saying if he is, if he ain't, but he looking a little smaller. I'm just saying, people lose weight, but they don't lose weight that fast, goddamn. All right, let's get back into it.
This soccer game, but beyond Drake just using these photos in an attempt to reverse the damage of the narratives that Kendrick tried to get across on his diss tracks, he also captioned the post, "Goats don't worry about one trick ponies," and this is what has everyone talking right now, because considering everything going on, this is without a doubt a direct shot at Kendrick. And first off, the fact that this caption is written better than any of the quotables on some of Drake's actual diss tracks, like The Hard Part 6, is absolutely hilarious. And overall, just by playing the captioning game right now, it only makes Kendrick's disses once again look stronger.
Okay, before we get too deep in the video, can we really say that that's a Kendrick diss? Or is that just a regular caption? Like, at what point, chat, do we end up saying, like, okay, people are reaching? Like, we all gotta admit, okay, again, I'm gonna state the obvious. Kendrick won the beef. Okay, cool. Drake has all these allegations against him, you know, everything everybody's saying, that's fine, but, like, how long are we going to keep reaching? You know what I'm saying? Like, is it a reach, first off? Like, hopefully he breaks it down for us. Is it a reach? But just outside looking in, before we get too deep in the video, it just kind of seems like a stretch. Like, let me just let it play.
And stronger, as they are only being further validated as we sit with them longer and just watch Drake spiral out of control and do everything that he said. When we look at Drake's first full-on attempt since The Hard Part 6 at trying to poke Kendrick Lamar and see what the asterisk he's trying to throw on this L now to make it look better is, it all really just gets more telling of the absolute state of delusion that Drake is stuck within. But in some ways, we have to give him some credit, because where Drake's attempts at saving his name and image with his two most recent features he has done have only backfired, what he's doing here is at least accomplishing something for him, I guess, because it has sparked a discussion around Drake and Kendrick that is making people question Lamar in some shape, and that's also helping Drake fans cope and really imagine that in actuality he is the winner of this feud. And this is because in the post, Drake is still standing on the fact that he is above Kendrick by first off.
All right, okay, so hold on. Like, I'm still trying to figure out, like, Chad, it almost feels like people are grasping at straws. Like, for instance, Kendrick just went and spoke at Compton Community College. Like, he ain't thinking about Drake. I mean, yes, Drake took the L, but at what point, like, it's like when you get your ass beat in the fight. Like, the first week, people at school gonna make fun of you. The second week, one or two people gonna make fun of you. The third week, people really, the black eye healed, people get over it. Now, I'm not saying you can get over the allegations against Drake. Let's keep that separate, y'all. Let's keep that separate. I'm strictly talking about rap right now. I'm talking about hip hop. So, like, he lost, but how long are we going to keep saying that, oh, they are beefing, they're beefing, they're beefing? I get it. As fans, we want more. We want more music from these two individuals just because it's very entertaining. But, like, Drake has to move on just like Kendrick moved on. So, I don't know. I still don't see how that caption ties to Kendrick at all, to be honest.
Of calling himself a GOAT, but much more substantially. Drake says that GOATs don't worry about one-trick ponies, and again, somehow, Drake's caption has better writing than whatever the absolute messes of everything he has given us since Family Matters has been, because this has a double meaning, as Drake okay. isn't just saying this phrase to describe Kendrick, but he's referring to a classic film, which, interesting enough, just as he referenced the Whitney Houston movie Bodyguard in Push Ups with a bar that he sure does regret and ended up becoming the basis for how personal Kendrick Lamar took everything, as he flat out stated on Meet the Grams. Here he is referring to the 1980 film One Trick Pony, and if you didn't think that this was intentional from Drake, between right. the fact that this film stars another musician in Paul Simon, which between Drake name-dropping two films starring very popular artists from decades past, definitely is some sort of trend or just thread he's trying to weave and keep up, but more eye-opening, and what confirms that Drake is just trying to re-aggravate Kendrick in some shape or form. The actual film One Trick Pony follows a story that, in Drake's mind, aligns with everything he has been trying to paint across about Kendrick throughout his diss tracks, as just reading what the synopsis of...
I'm a little young, so I ain't seen that movie, Chad. Have y'all seen that movie? One Trick Pony? Should I watch it? Like, not despite of what Drake talking about, I'm just saying, is it a good movie? Should I watch it? I don't know. Let me know.
...of this film is. We can see exactly what Drake was doing with this caption, as it says, Jonah is an aging rock star trying to put together a new album in the face of an indifferent record label and a talentless producer. At the same time, he is struggling to save his marriage. And I won't lie, this is clever on Drake's end, but at the same time, I think...
Okay... Let's go back. Let's read that. Let's go over that one more time. All right. So this is a little brief synopsis about the movie. It says, Jonah is an aging rock star trying to put together a new album in the face of an indifferent record label and a talentless producer. At the same time, he's struggling to save his failing marriage. So now, before we get into it, first off, shout out to Hip Hop News, bro. Like, to even make that connection, like I said, I ain't never seen the movie. I ain't never even heard the movie. But to make that connection is crazy. That means Drake really be sitting at the crib just thinking about Kendrick like that. But secondly, bro, do y'all think he's talking about Kendrick in a way? Do y'all think that Drake is saying Kendrick is like that main character in the movie? What do y'all think? Like I said, I ain't seen the movie. I don't know. But that's a hell of a connection. That's crazy.
Struggling to save his marriage. And I won't lie, this is clever on Drake's end, but at the same time, I think this is showing us that while it may seem like Drake may be trying to start a round two with Kendrick by once again dissing him to his millions of followers, I think what we will find out soon and what's actually going on is that Drake is now implementing a new strategy to save his career that isn't actually trying to put him within a musical duel with Kendrick again, as we all know how bad that went. But it's trying to get ahead of the even further damage control that is going to need to be done when Kendrick Lamar's Pop Out and Friends concert goes down in LA very soon, and when the rollout for his teased and highly anticipated album begins.
Somebody said Juneteenth. Drake don't know nothing about that.
Because Drake knows at this point, any success Kendrick Lamar sees, whether the music is about him or not, is only going to hurt his reputation, as we will see Kendrick get more and more praise and prove that his claims about there being no big three become perceived as fact by more and more people when it comes to MCs that offer the complete artistic package just beyond the optics of hype, streams, and sales. Drake has at least realized that he is going to have to get a lot more tactical to walk out of what is pretty much going to be wave two of negativity towards him in any sort of position of strength. And he is doing this now by beginning to weave together a narrative around Kendrick, which is trying to diminish his success and legitimacy as an artist, as he is painting him out to be a lost individual whose career is no longer in the state of success that it once was, and now he is on the search to regain any sort of relevance as his personal life falls apart.
So that's interesting. I don't know too much about Kendrick's personal life. I mean, at the end of the day, I like to try to stay in rap. I like to try to stay on the factual side of things. Like, again, I don't like to play too much into allegations because it's just a dark, slippery slope, bro. You don't really know what you're going to get into until something is proven. So I really like to stick to that. But I say all that to say, let's go back to the concert that Kendrick is going to be doing on Juneteenth. First off, I wish I was in the city to go see that. I'm all the way out on the other side of the country. I wish I could go see that. But secondly, I really hope Kendrick don't make this whole thing literally just about this and Drake. You get what I'm saying? Like, I really hope Kendrick goes out there, puts on a show, brings some people from the city, you know what I'm saying? They put on a real good concert. Because I feel like if you go out there and you literally just make it about bashing Drake the whole time, again, bad publicity is good publicity. Any publicity is good publicity. You get what I'm saying? It's just, it kind of seems like I would think, right, if Kendrick went out there and made that whole thing about dissing Drake, that he is trying to use Drake for a stimulus package. Now, before y'all get on my ass, I'm not saying Kendrick needs to do that. Kendrick right now has the platform to drop an album and be the biggest he's ever been in his entire career. So I don't know if Drake actually thinks Kendrick is slipping out of his career or he's past his prime, because Kendrick has the stage. Kendrick has the floor. Kendrick got all of our eyes and ears open. If he drops even a poem, we all gonna listen to it, right? Let's be real. But I really, really hope this concert is not about Drake. For one, Juneteenth has a deep-rooted history for all of us color people anyway. If y'all don't know anything about the black community, the black history, the black anything, just go ahead and look up Juneteenth and y'all can really see why I'm hoping that concert is not just about Drake, because that would just defeat the whole purpose of him throwing that concert on Juneteenth. Don't y'all agree? Like, yes, they should clown him. They should go crazy, but only a part of it. But let him cook.
And while Drake trying to push across this narrative to his fans that are willing to believe just about anything he says, that Kendrick is a one-trick pony because he can only gain relevance from mentioning Drake's name and that his music is also one-dimensional. Just like a lot of the things Drake has done. When you really consider what these claims are stating and see how they hold up to Kendrick, anybody will see that from the 5 tracks Kendrick released throughout this feud alone, there's never been this amount of artistic range being shown at once, as from a Metro Boomin club banger to a gritty Alchemist beat to a DJ Mustard loop that channels everything his greatness and the West Coast stands for. Kendrick showed that he really is the ultimate MC, as he can plug his abilities into every corner of the rap world and beyond this. While this has started a debate already where Drake stans are arguing that because Drake can sing and hop onto so many different waves of music, he is more versatile, I think it is important to remember that versatility isn't just about how many different styles of music you can dip your feet into, but that it's also about the range of music you can operate in at a high level. And when you compare this, and you see how Drake gets criticized for riding trends and copying musical styles with no creativity whatsoever, and see how Kendrick is able to bend himself and his abilities into songs as popular as Travis Scott's Goosebumps, but also as gritty and abstract as Danny Brown's Really Dough off the experimental hip-hop masterpiece Atrocity Exhibition.
Hey, this is actually an amazing piece of work. If y'all ain't checked this out, definitely go check this out. It's an amazing piece of work.
Don't get me wrong, Drake's versatility is incredible for what it is, but it is easy to lose sight of how shallow it gets beyond just hopping on a trend or dipping his toes into something, as opposed to Kendrick, who can go all in on anything and be his best self from decade-defining hits to the most intense of deep cuts. So to bring this full circle and see how while Drake is trying to prepare for the sea of attacks that are going to come right back at him as Kendrick Lamar kicks into gear what is up next for his rap career. Despite the tactics of this move being smart, as he is trying to create a safety net for him and begin to redirect how people perceive Kendrick's victory and his abilities as an MC. And as a result, is trying to plant a seed that will end up making Kendrick Lamar's upcoming album look desperate and that it needed Drake to succeed. Outside of his fan base, who has shown that they will twist anything out there to cope with the reality of what has been an all-time low year for Drake, is any of this enough to really sway the public opinion about Drake right now and make people discredit Kendrick Lamar? Because while Drake has been trying to build this narrative already that Kendrick is so desperate and hungry for attention, and then he's using this beef for promotion, people have already rejected this idea. And as Drake continues to stay outside,
I mean, okay, all right, it's crazy. Like, I don't think that there's anybody out there. I mean, unless Drake is that delusional, which is possible, but how is there anybody out there that could think Kendrick needs to diss Drake in order to make the hype around his album good? Literally any Kendrick album that has dropped in my lifetime, the last 12, Good Kid, Mad City, all these albums, right? Like, I don't even need to name them, brother. They all went, what, platinum? Is platinum the highest you can go? I think diamond. I don't know if they went diamond, but I know for a fact they all went platinum. like Mr. Morale, I think, is the only one that's like gold. It might be platinum by now. Like, so how can you say that Kendrick, or how can you think that Kendrick needs Drake to do anything? Now, let's switch lanes a little bit. I do think that Kendrick is a smart man. He's a businessman. His music is his job. So, of course, he knows that dissing one of the biggest artists in the game is going to give him publicity for his album. I'm not going to sit here and say that that's wrong. He should do that because his job is literally to sell records. That's how he feeds his family. That's how he puts clothes on his back. So he should use this as a steam, you know, as a power up for his album. I like it. I like the rollout because then it makes us excited for this album. Now, with that being said, though, I like Mr. Morale. Like, it's not one of my favorites. It's definitely not one of my favorites by Kendrick. It's a good, solid album, though. I don't want another Mr. Morale. Coming off of what we just came from, what you just eat, drink, and drink like this, I personally don't want a Mr. Morale. Now, you could put a little bit of that on the album, maybe on the deluxe or the back end or the front end, but we need that Kendrick that you just gave us on Euphoria. We need that Kendrick you gave us on Not Like Us. You get what I'm saying? I feel like all the rap fans can agree with me. We want Kendrick to make some Kendrick shit. Pull up, drink. Has, you know what I'm saying? Which that song had a meaning about Kendrick's alcoholism and stuff, but it was still a banger. We need those, bro. We need those.
Side, and at the end of the day, beyond the layers of this social media post, which is already pathetic to just do all of this when considering this is a rap beef and people want to see everything settled with a microphone. At the end of the day, all of this is only making him look worse as it's proving everything Kendrick said to be true. What does this man not understand? So all in all, if you are Drake, please go into hiding for a while, let this pass, and try to come back stronger, because with these clownish antics that are showing him to be not over this beef one bit, and that are still trying to change a score that has already been written in the books, he's only going to destroy every single thing that he stands for, so let me know. What do you think about the newest moment and what I'm going to call the never-ending downfall of Drake? I can't wait to hear what you have to say, and if you want to see what Drake's worst song is, and how it did one-of-a-kind damage to his career while also seeing other rappers who stained their own careers forever by releasing songs that embarrassed them to the highest degree, check out the suggested video on the worst song popular.
Alright, so W video by Hip Hop News, man. Definitely a W video. Definitely some W taste from there. And some definitely interesting things that make you shift your point of view a little bit. Now, there were some things said, right, where he's like, you know, Drake's career is damaged or whatever the case is. He said something along the lines of that. Let's just keep it 100%, right? And no matter what you think about Drake, no matter what I think about Drake, Drake's going to have all the accolades he already has. We can't take them away. Like, you could think Drake is the worst person in the world, but it doesn't take the fact that he's been charting on Billboard for how many weeks, how many decades, right? It doesn't take away the fact that he was the artist of the decade. You know, it doesn't take away from the fact that he had all these accolades and things that are already attached to his name. So we can't take those away. So I don't say that his career is damaged, because Drake, they're at the tail end of their career. It's sad to say, but Drake and Kendrick are mid-30s. Like, we need somebody else that should be coming up by now. So I don't think that Drake's career is definitely damaged. It's stained for sure because he lost to Kendrick. But honestly, if my career is going to be stained, I would like it to be stained, pause, no Diddy, by losing to Kendrick as well. Now, again, let's keep this in mind, because I know y'all minds be shifting. I'm only talking about rap. I'm not talking about the allegations or where Drake may like or may not like. That's none of my business. That's aside from music. We keeping the hip hop here, right? So I don't think that Drake's career is just like, oh, as soon as we think about Drake, yeah, because it's fresh, we're gonna think about the Kendrick Lamar beef. But let's say 10 years from now, when you think about Drake, we're gonna see him on that. You know how they used to give Michael Jackson all the awards when he was still around, all the BET awards for artist of the century and all this other stuff. I do feel like Drake would still be considered for stuff like that. I don't think this beef has literally just chopped Drake's head off the Mount Rushmore for a lot of people. Don't get me wrong, for a lot of people. Now let's switch over to Kendrick. I also don't think Kendrick needed Drake to roll out his new album. We all know he didn't, because Kendrick has gone platinum on his own without dissing Drake for quite some time now. Like, let's be real now. You know what I'm saying? So, I don't know. I don't know 100% if this was another Drake diss to Kendrick, but definitely tying it to that movie, I could definitely see that POV. But again, who is in Drake's camp? Like, leave Kendrick alone. If this was actually a Kendrick diss, why? What are you doing? Like, what are you doing? Like, okay, if he is trying to spin the narrative before this concert coming up that Kendrick is doing, like, okay. whatever. I mean, if that's what you want to do, I would say he should have just stayed silent and then maybe dropped a song on the day of the concert. But even then, that would be terrible because Juneteenth is for us. And for you to try to make it about you, not saying that, I don't want to get it. I don't want to get too racially into it. But like, just I'm sticking with the narrative that Drake is not like us, right? Okay, I'm sticking with that narrative. So for him to drop a song even on the day of the concert, that would be a bad look too. So honestly, Drake does need to just do whatever it is he wants to do as far as music and leave Kendrick alone. Don't mention Kendrick. Don't diss Kendrick. Hell, don't diss nobody. Just stay to your goddamn self. But anyways, man, if y'all like this video, make sure y'all hit that like button. If you like my commentary, go ahead and subscribe because I be dropping these videos back to back to back to back to back, goddamn. And shit, that's going to be it from your boy Frankie. I'm going to catch y'all on the next one. Later, later.